This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I want to show how to calculate an IV drip rate. So here's the first problem. This one says, the order is for 1,800 milliliters of a saline solution to be infused in 12 hours. The drop factor is 8 GTT, or 8 drops per milliliter. What drip rate should be used? Okay, so we're going to start out with the order. We'll write that on the left here for the beginning of the equation. That's 1,800 milliliters over, what was the time? 12 hours. Let's put in an equal sign, and over on the right, we'll put the units we want to end up with. We want to end up with drops per minute, so we'll have GTT over minutes. And then the other information we're given is that the drop factor is 8 drops per milliliter. So let's put that fraction in next. We use that to multiply the order. That's 8 GTT per milliliter. And the one more thing we have to do, since we've got hours over here, we want to end up with minutes, is use a fraction to convert that. So I'm going to have 1 hour over 60 minutes. Now let's cancel out the units that we can. We can cancel out the milliliters, and we can cancel out hours, and that leaves us with just GTT and minutes, which is what we want to end up with. And now let's simplify these numbers before we multiply. I've got an 8 over here and a 12 over here. I could divide both of those by 4. So 8 divided by 4 is 2, and 12 divided by 4 is 3. I've got a 3 and an 1800. I could divide both of those by 3. 3 into 18 goes 6 times, so 3 into 1800 would go 600 times, and 3 divided by 3 is just 1. Then I've got 660. Let's divide both of those by 60. So 600 divided by 60 is 10. 60 divided by 60 is just 1. I've just got 1s in the denominator, 1s at the minutes, of course. So let's multiply the numerators. That's 10 times 2 GTT. So 10 times 2 is 20. So I'm going to end up with 20 GTT, or 20 drops per minute. Okay, so the basic approach was all I did, I multiplied the order times the drop factor. I used a conversion, and that gave me my answer. Let's do one more of these. This says, the order is for an infusion of 2 liters in 24 hours. If the solution on hand has a drop factor of 15, what drip rate should be used? Okay, so we'll start out with the order. That's 2 liters over 24 hours. Let's put in the equal sign and the units we want. Once again, we're dealing with drops per minute, GTT over minutes. The drop factor is 15, so that's 15 GTT per milliliter. We'll have to do some conversions. We've got hours, and we want to end up with minutes. So we'll put in 1 hour over 60 minutes. And we've also got liters and milliliters, so to be able to cancel both of those out, I'll put in the fraction 1,000 milliliters over 1 liter. Now let's cancel the units that we can. So I've got liters here and liters here. They'll cancel. The hours will cancel out. The milliliters will cancel out. And I've just got GTT in the numerator and minutes in the denominator. Now let's simplify these fractions if we can. So I've got 2 over 24. I can divide both of those by 2. 2 divided by 2 is just 1. 24 divided by 2 is 12. Then I've got a 15 and a 12. I could divide both of those by 3. So 15 divided by 3 is 5. And 12 divided by 3 is 4. I've got a 5 and 60. I can divide both of those by 5. So the 5 divided by 5 is just 1. 60 divided by 5 is 12. I've got 4 in the denominator and 1,000. I could divide both of those by 4. So 4 divided by 4 is 1. 1,000 divided by 4 is 250. And let's see what I've got left. Just the 250 and the 12, they're both even numbers. So let's divide both of those by 2. 250 divided by 2 is 125. 12 divided by 2 is 6. I can't reduce those numbers anymore. So I'm going to have 125 over 6. So if we take this fraction and put it into a calculator, we're going to find out that 125 over 6 equals 20.8. So that would be 20.8 drops per minute. So we're going to round this number. 20.8 is, this is, the 8 is 5 or greater. So this is going to become 21 drops per minute. Okay, so once again, we did exactly the same approach. We took the order, multiplied it by the drop factor, used whatever conversions we needed to, canceled out everything that we could, got our answer. Since it was a fraction, we found out what it equaled as a decimal, and then we rounded it. Okay, so that's about it. I hope this helps. Take care, and I'll see you next time.